tell you a little more about me, to my name. I was born and raised in Athens, Illinois, out in the country. Grew up as a very artistic family. We've always done art, as you can see from the picture. We also had style, and we had one of you, because we had our own pool. That's me and my sister there. I've been doing illustrations and murals almost, like I said, since I was a kid. This is a mural that I did last year at a pool out by Rochester. It's a 65-foot mural. This is just one section of it. This last summer. Thank God there was a pool there. That's all I can say. It's a west facing wall. I burned very well. We hooked up with DSI. We talk about this mural downtown, and they showed me this wall, which is the wall right there next to where the farmer's market is. And said, come up with a design. Can you come up with something to do during this? I was like, yeah, definitely. So I kind of want to do something a little like retro, some old advertising, something that looked really cool. So I kind of put this together. And this is just something I put together kind of quick. This is a fun concept. But I love the old advertising. I think it ties into downtown, ties into architecture. Something like this on a wall next to the farmer's market is beautiful. It's going to make people really see it, take pictures, and make it. Tourists just love being downtown more. So I kind of got thinking, what else can I do downtown? So I went to that building next door, the Shannon Barnes, which they redid this off, it's great, but that wall, not so great. So I said, what could I do to kind of tie in the architecture? It's kind of the old Art Deco, Tony style look, and I love old advertising, so I came up with this. And again, it looks kind of daunting, but to be honest with you, something like this really is not that hard to paint. It's a lot of block painting. It's a lot of sectioning off. Again, this is just a quick concept. I love that Tony style. Man. I can't say that enough. It's a beautiful painting. Traffic is chasing them all down that street, but still. And then I was in the Bicari building. This is one of the things. As you come in through 6th Street, everybody sees this building, but you know, I kind of looked at it like, wow, that's canvas. And I was like, what would tourists want to see as they're coming down that street into our downtown area? So I put together this little number. And that's basically, I think, called a Lincoln promo poster for when it's running. Either that or it's a nice fake. Either way, it's big. It's quite a few stories big. But again, it's not that hard to paint. We got a lot of talented people in Springfield. And I'm sure we can get a lot of people. I would love to work on something like this. My next stop was people at the Amtrak station. I know this might be moved to 10th Street. So. As they're sitting there waiting for a train, and as people are coming in, I noticed going to Chicago, the beautiful murals all the way up there. This wall is gorgeous, these ring houses on the wall is nice, and they're nice people. But what would I do to show off tourism and kind of highlight Springfield? So I did something like this. Obviously, it's, again, it's just a quick Photoshop thing, but thank you for your smiles. Definitely, show off Lincoln. Maybe tie in Amtrak, get them to sponsor it, pay for it, maybe. Show them where they're at and just, just promoting our town. Then this is the A1 Block Company. Again, nothing is a business, that's just a nice wall. Driving up Washington Street, you can see this for miles. Everyone coming off the train or going in the parking lot sees it. And I was like, well, okay, what would look nice here? And so, again, I kind of thought that I'd get those down, so I found some old advertising and kind of jazzed it up. It's striking. Again, not that hard to paint. But in hindsight, I'd probably take the lettering and move it up to the side so that people can actually see it and maybe remove the cigarette. And this is the Brio. Well, it's not the Brio, but this is the building of Brio's in. I know that just basically the side looks great. But again, this is another wall as you're coming into downtown that people can see for miles and miles. Blocks, just kind of looking at that, I was like, I just need something. That's really nice, it's really pretty. So I found this, which is an old Vogue catalog. And I just kind of put that on the wall to kind of just get some ideas on that. I was like, I don't know, I got sick. So you just kind of but again, you do something like that with shopping downtown, maybe downtown, the old promo that DSI is doing, the time grip guy. This wall, I see every day going to work. So this is on 4th Street. It's the motor parking was above. It looks like it had trouble going through it. Again, I know they've done a lot on that block, but this side of the wall coming up 4th Street is an eyesore. So what would I do with that wall? I would first take down that hat thing and put up some cool old advertising. People love this stuff. Just imagine all the tourists come and say, oh my gosh, you buy it here. But again, it's one of those things that looks really complicated. It's really not. I mean, you have a lot of block painting. It's easy to put on there. It doesn't have to be any that's just a thing I saw. I was like, it's cool, it's a little cowboys. And then I thought about this. The guest capital is a ton of money going down the avenue, fixing up, but then you have this big black bar going across the capital. So I was like, let's get creative, let's get out of the box. What can we do to this? And so I kind of cheated a little bit on this one. little Photoshop work. It scans just the right spot. I have a picture. It has to be the exact right time of the stairs and put the trees. But I like that one. And this one, I thought, you know, let's give homage to Springfield's finest residents. I don't know why this spoke to me in this way, but I like this. This is Monroe, right next to the post office. But I was like, let's pay homage to Springfield's. Has a place in my heart. There you go, Simpsons, you can't be more Springfield than that. I don't know if that would really fly with the building owners, but it looks cool. And again, I just have tons of ideas. I actually have about 10 more of these that I could fit on the slides. Lots of ideas. I have a lot of talent in this town. You know, let's use it and talk to some things.